recording already.
We're in San Francisco right now!
Look! The Golden Gate Bridge!
Hi, and welcome to HP How To For You. I'm Steph, and this is Bill.
Hey, guys.
And we both work for the HP's customer support organization.
And we're here in San Francisco. We're at the Global Social Customer Care Meetup for the support forums. We have 7 languages that are covered with the support forums. We have experts who are customers just like you answering questions in those forums that are here in San Francisco with us. We have questions of the day that we ask each day, and we're going to have these experts give you their responses to them.
These guys have traveled from near and far. We have some people who are up here in San Francisco that just live in Palo Alto, some of us from Boise, and then we also have people here from
South America, Asia, Europe, everywhere. It's incredible. We're really lucky to have them all here in one place and be able to get these guys to respond to questions for you guys, so that they'll give you their tips, their tricks to help you use your PC better. We have an expert. You guys might know him, Mr. Do. Here's Kevin of the Kevin and Randy Show. So, Kevin, what are you most excited about for Windows 10?
It's free. And awesome. Beyond that, the features. When you talk of the features, I like in Edge the ability to change a lot of things. I like that in the top right corner you can click this little book-looking icon and it turns it into a readable format that doesn't have autoplay, doesn't have advertisements, clears it out, and you can just go through it and it's fast and easy to use. That's my favorite so far.
O, dla mnie, ja jestem bardzo podekscytowanym tym nowym feature, która będzie nazywała się kartoną. Można się zapytać wszystkiego i odpowiedzi na jaki masz problem albo jak chcesz informacje znaleźć. Będzie po prostu, możesz się zapytać i ci da odpowiedź.
I like the new browser, Edge.
Cortana is a very high potential feature of Windows 10.
The start button. No, Cortana, no, snackable Wi-Fi. I think snackable Wi-Fi is my answer. No, Cortana, it's Cortana. I think Cortana is my answer. Because Cortana is probably my favorite game character, so I want, you know, I always want her to deliver a dropship to me, and now I get to talk to her every day.
The best way to keep your PC running great is to make sure you're installing the latest updates and running the HP Support Assistant, which is going to keep your machine with the latest drivers and the latest software running great.
The best thing to do is install HP Support Assistant.
Do your updates.
Olá pessoal, tudo bom? Minha dica de hoje é para prevenir, você otimizar a velocidade do seu computador é o seguinte. Antes de você instalar qualquer programa, qualquer software, você precisa ter um cuidado especial com alguns ícones que tá marcado lá. Por exemplo, alguns toolbars se instalam junto com o seu computador e isso causa uma lentidão muito, muito grande.
Don't trust anything you see on the internet. Don't click on things. Don't go after a Java update that didn't come to you from java.com. All of those things are the things that bring your PC down. They install behind, you end up having to run programs later to try and remove them. They hog your resources. Don't do it. Trust nothing.
Running the HP Support Assistant.
Try to do a recovery on your computer at least once a year. It's a good way to kind of get rid of some of these things that you don't use, applications that you might not be using. And then if you organize yourself on the computer, backing things up will make your life a lot easier.
So update your PC. Keeping your PC updated is the single most important thing you can do. That includes Windows updates, BIOS updates, and software updates from HP. Use HP Support Assistant to keep it up to date. Make sure you're on the latest version of the BIOS.
Do all your updates on time, both HP and Microsoft. And keep your antivirus also up to date. That'll be good.
I'm most excited about 3D printing.
Pues hoy en día la tecnología que pienso que es más interesante de HP son las impresoras de 3D, las de tercera dimensión.
Naja, sehr, sehr interessant waren jetzt der Beitrag über die 3D-Drucker.
And actually the all-in-one remote app is coming down automatically from Microsoft when you install any of our printers, any of our software. And it just magically appears.
3D printing, because I believe that this technology can change how the thing is made.
Principalmente agora nessa parte de tecnologia de impressão, é interessante mesmo o modo de tintas da HP, aonde ela vê agora somente pela natureza, né?
HP's Instant Ink Program. Customers never have to go out and buy ink. It's always delivered before they need it, and it's a great value.
3D-Druck an sich ist wirklich das interessanteste Ding, weil man extrem viel machen kann.
The thing that I'm most excited about is 3D printing.
When you're looking for a new printer or a PC, what do you look for?
Well, what I look for is a specification, and by that I mean, you know, with the processor, RAM, and the hard drive type that fits what I do with a PC. I look for fast boot, large storage, and if I'm running anything complicated, where it be like Adobe Photoshop or big spreadsheets or any type of design software, will it run fine on that PC? And if it does, then you know it's going to work for everything else. And for printing, I'm just going to say I'm a laser guy. I look for really high quality print.
That's a good answer. You said one thing that caught my attention was fast boot. What's the best thing for fast boot?
Oh, by far. SSD backed it up with a 2 terabyte or 3 terabyte hard drive to store all your data.
For PC, I'll get a Omen, HP Omen.
With respect to PC, I should be able to play games without any hassles.
If I know I need something very powerful for video processing, I'll look for something with a bigger CPU, plenty of memory. But I try to identify my needs first. Then I go and see what's available on the market. If there's something, a new tablet, something perhaps, something I want to make sure it's got the latest operating system. So I look for something that's up to date, that has all the specifications that I need.
First of all, the first thing I would like to understand is what is their need, of course. You know, if they're going to print a lot, print less. Well, if they're going to print photos, documents, you know, to better understand their needs.
What's your price range, one, right? What do you feel like you could spend? And then what are the things you want to do with it? Do you want to work with photos? Do you want to do videos? Do you want to just surf the web? And if you're willing to say, okay, I just want this, I don't need to go higher, then you just kind of start looking at your price range in those areas, because there is something at every price range with HP. Do you want it really fast? Then go more memory and more processor speed. And when it comes to those things, every number that's higher is better.
We are here in San Francisco at the closing of the HP Experts Global Meetup in San Francisco. Everybody's gone, so we just want to say so long, everybody.
Bye! Bye. Catch our next episode in 2 weeks!
We did it.
Awesome.
Oh, thanks, guys. Now you know the frustration that Stephanie goes through every stinking episode.
I'm not always this social, but when I am, I'm at the HP Global Social Customer Care Meetup in San Francisco with Stephanie.
We're here eating churros at the game.
Giants
game. Oh my gosh, San Francisco Giants.
Bye.
Catch us next in...